Right, hello everybody and welcome back into Euro Truck Simulator 2. We're playing in 32-bit mode today. We're in 64-bit mode some days, we're in 32-bit mode today. And we'll be getting back on the job. I think we did our delivery, didn't we, yesterday? We completed our delivery. It would be, I'm not sure if it was yesterday, but there's nothing on the job list up here at the top, so I think so. We're in Aberdeen. And we are going to look and see what jobs we have. Quite a bit of activity going on in Aberdeen, it looks like, at the moment. 100,000 to Budapest with a tank. 100,000 is that's a bit of dough, isn't it? Alternatively, we can go to Rotterdam. This, I think, was in the yard where we delivered, as was this bus to Dortmund. There is a tank to Croydon, which I like the look of that tank, actually. So I think that's going to be the job, unless there's something better here, which there's some cars there. Not your average cars, either. There's some pretty nice ones. I do like these tanks as well, but I'm quite interested in this tank here, which is a petrol tank, as we'd say in Ireland. So, and it's a pretty urgent delivery, so 14 hours of a trip. We're going to set that and we're going to check our situation. 4.5 hours. Yeah, we'll have to go and see where this is. I don't think it's here. No, it isn't. Let's take on a couple of lights here when we're at it. And I think it's over this way. Fuel-wise, I think we're going to be fine. But I don't know if we actually will be able to make this trip. Well, it's in here. Ooh, excuse me. We are yawning again, of course. Wrong way offense. Really. I went wide in the gate and it's a wrong way offense. Was I driving on the wrong side of the road there? I was, wasn't I? You gobshite. I was driving on the wrong side of the road. I'm in England, I should be in the ditch. Well, I deserved that offense. Okay. Some fairly nice tanks up here by the looks of things, folks. Big ones as well. There's a shiny one with Samad written on it. There's a white one with six colored boxes. And this is our one, which is the Schwarzmuller. And that's full of gasoline, as the Americans would say. We can connect up onto this. Make sure that's connected. Let's give it a clink. Makes an ungodly bounce, doesn't it? Right, distance. We have 24 hours remaining to deliver it. It's 14 hours of a journey. It is Wednesday at 11:51 and it needs to be there basically by this time tomorrow, essentially. So it's not so far away at all. We have to remember not to drive on the wrong side of the road, because we do have a tendency to be a bit of a gobshite when it comes to forgetting which side of the road we're on. I will wait, because driving out in front of them with a fuel tank is a bit silly. Driving out in front of this one with a fuel tank is a little bit less silly, because I'm not crossing him in the opposite direction. Okay. Let's get ourselves out here and make sure we're clear. Throw a bit of an indication on there. There's nothing coming up on that side. Nothing coming up on that side, so I think we're going to be all right. And we are on the road. So 14 hours means we do need to drive out most of the 4 hours of our driving window that we currently have. And if we do that, then we should be in pretty good timing. That'll be 4 hours, which will leave us with 20. We'll sleep for 8 or whatever it is. with 11 hours remaining to do the 10 hours driving. So it's all a bit tight, as in there's not an awful lot of room for dilly-dallying or what you want to call it. But it's doable. We can get her done. Which is nice. I like this kind of part of the game, or the sim. I call it a game. Well, there is a kind of a gaming component to it, undoubtedly. But the sense of having to work out, how to, achieve your goal, that's interesting. And I think a lot more could be made of that as well. And not just the sense of a kind of blind driving, you know. Took a very wide turn there, didn't we? But wide turns are okay. Like, there's a fuel station coming up, and there's probably room to stay over. So we could kind of go and get some sleep, but we would be wasting up to 3.5 hours, what's left, practically 4 hours of driving. And we need those 4 hours of driving in order to be able to get down. We can only drive for 11 hours. It's a 14-hour trip. That leaves 3 over. So I have to drive at least 3 of these in order to be able to make it down. That kind of stuff is kind of interesting to me. Load planning and things like that. I suppose it could become as complicated as you like, and, well, frankly speaking, it could easily become too complicated as well, so there's a balance that's needed, and what that balance is to be determined. But I'm remembering to use my retarder here now, which is making a difference. Didn't look like there was any back wheels on that tractor trailer, on that trailer unit. So the scenery is what the scenery is. What time is it anyway? It's 12:23. So it's just past, it's just past noon. We're up to a nice 43,308 kilometers on the count right now. So we're knocking away at the, chipping away, as you'd say, at another 10,000 to bring ourselves up to 50,000, which would represent half of the intended life of this truck, as I will be driving it before I hand it over to somebody new, which is awesome. And then the decision is what to get next. It's a bit too early to start talking about that for me. Well, actually, it's never too early to start talking about trucks and stuff. I do suppose I might go back to the Mercedes. I do think I might. But then there's a man and there's a DAF and some of it is going to come down to just, I think some of the features. I think the DAF has got a really slow windscreen wiper, and that's probably going to annoy me. Because, let's face it, a slow windscreen wiper is annoying. And if you don't think it's annoying, then I'm sorry, but you're wrong. Although, maybe you don't think it's annoying, in which case you're not wrong. Oh, there I go, sitting on the fence. You're wrong. You're totally wrong. You just have to accept it that a slow windscreen, that's difficult to say, windscreen, a slow windscreen wiper, WSW, windscreen wiper, say that fast. Probably you can. It just really bugged me. And the other thing that was really annoying was the indicator, indication, the audible click or indicator that your indicator was working, if you know what I mean. That was painfully slow as well, possibly even more annoying than the windscreen wiper. Yeah. So we'll have to go and check those things out before we go ahead and make a final decision on what to buy next. But anyway. Of course, there is an upgrade to this Volvo that's out there. So that's another possibility. I did have a quick look at scale models for trucks, and there's a couple of manufacturers out there who appear to produce pretty cool trucks. Now, a lot of them have got electronics in their motors and motors and remote control stuff, which is a bit more than I would need, and most of them are 1 to 24 or 1 to 27 scale, which is a bit big for a kind of a desk thing. I was kind of wondering if there was a 1 to 72 scale type truck that was out there, or 1 to 32nd, 1 to 48 actually would probably be a very good compromise. 1 to 72 would be decent though. Be small enough that it wouldn't take up too much desk space, but big enough that it would represent a fairly detailed model. 1 to 48 obviously is bigger, but I guess you could actually have even more detail and, you know, possibly open up the hood or a closed panel or something and have a little bit going on there. However, the models that I've seen so far don't appear to be necessarily the same as your typical Airfix model set. Having said that, I think I have more research to do in order to find out exactly what the plan would be. But I think it would make a pretty nice piece of desk art. And given that I like trucks so much, then disc art it would be. Paint it up, do it in my own colors. Be quite interesting to see if I could replicate some of the paint jobs in here in real world. That would be probably beyond my capability in all due respect. Right, well, I'm not using the wipers because it's not so bad at the moment. And I'm a bit of a don't use a wiper unless I need to use a wiper kind of person. Some people turn the wipers on as soon as there's a drop. I think it might be due to the I don't know. I don't know why I do that. But I can see perfectly well. So, excuse me, so I'm not turning on the wipers. We are in convoy here. We're not doing a great speed. We're ticking along here at about 60. Which is pedestrian enough, really. But we are in convoy. We're on brows of hills on a single lane road, and there's not really enough of opportunity for overtaking, so we just get ourselves into a position here, work out what the guy in front is doing, and then stick her on cruise and follow along. So weight-wise, we have 25 tons, so we're pretty heavy. We're heading to Croydon. 12.5 hours, we've done 2 hours and change. So we're motoring along here handy enough, I suppose. I do like the fact that in the latest update they've put in different speeds of wipers, and there is this wiper set that is, there's a bit of an intermittent. My own car has, the same as your cars, I'm sure, a number of different speeds. There's only two that have been programmed in here. This is the other one, which means that it just bounces back up and then it's completely off. Mine has a bit of a longer gap between each stroke, as its lowest setting on my car. And I really miss a feature that was on an older car of mine, where you could change the period that it stops between each stroke. So you could make it longer or you could make it shorter, and that is a feature that I would use. But it doesn't exist on my Ikari, so get a bit of slowdown going forward here, and see if we can make it up. bring it around nice and steady on the throttle, give her some jolly, and up we go. Bit of a load here now, she'll knock down the speed quite a bit in maybe a couple of gears. Need to be watching that mirror, otherwise we will be in trouble. And well, he drove into me and I'm offended. That's a bit silly. My indicator wasn't on. Well, it was and I turned it off. I do have a little bit of a concern about that particular fine. I don't think that was necessarily my fault. I mean, there is a kind of a courtesy required for the other guy to move over. I mean, what is the point? I do need the resume function now, I'm beginning to realize. On my cruise control, it's beginning to become an important feature, and I don't have it programmed onto any button. So I can just click it back on, and if it's within whatever limit, it'll start accelerating me automatically again. Gosh, take your eye off the road for a minute and you're weaving all over it. Madness, it is madness. So anyway, I shall continue looking to see what models are available that I can build. I think it might be cool to run one of those as a little bit of a video series. I think I may have spoken about it previously, but I do have some intentions to do that with some aircraft. But I'm beginning to think that a truck would be a good idea. I think I would have a pretty good motivation to get into it with a truck as well. Now, there's some folks that are pretty switched on with all this stuff, and they're doing battleships and spaceships and lots of, you know, pretty impressive big-scale stuff. Small scale on the desk, but, you know, big scale in the real world, so lots of detail in there as well, and it's all fiddly minor tweaky stuff. I don't think I'm nearly ready to take on something like that. And I don't tend to have a big pull towards, you know, rebuilding the Bismarck or something, for example. Although I do find myself studying ships or any models that I come across when I come across them with a little degree of impressed, of being impressed impression. It's really a testament to the folks that have put them together. The amount of just patience that you need, and I think that's the thing that is also a bit of a development opportunity for me, is to have the patience and the delicateness to go and put this kind of stuff together. So, plans are afoot to do that along with everything else. This evening when I got back, unfortunately I got interrupted, but I had a bit of energy to go and start moving stuff here. It does mean that I need to make use of one of the spaces that we parked our car in. We have we might have to park that on the street for a couple of days just to allow me a bit of room to move stuff around. But instead today I got distracted as usual into the garden to finish something off that took a little bit longer. One thing led to the other, and I'm not going to move stuff around just yet. I do believe I have a weekend up here on my own this coming weekend. My wife has some travel, so it'll just be me, myself, and I, and I think the three of us should be able to make a solid start on the plans here and get some of the garage organized. We are in trouble. Do not break. Jeez. He is still breaking, and I don't know why. Please, don't be an idiot. I am getting tired. Well, yeah. What does that tell me? I've got 38 minutes, so I've actually... Well, I haven't heard the yawns, have I? Have there been yawns? Anybody remember? My yawns, of course, yes. But I'm not talking about my yawns, I'm talking about the Avatar's yawns. Have there been any yawns that I've missed? There must have been. Well, maybe he's going to move on and I won't need to pull over. So with 38 minutes and we have services coming up in 200 yards, it's like as if it was planned, isn't it? Look at that, 29 minutes. We've driven 4 hours. I'll stick a bit of a brake on here now and try and go in here with a little bit of a rich spark. We're on the right side here. I'm just wondering if I can get her over and park over here. I think I will be able to park over here. It's just now a question of... Petrol in the petrol station. It's brilliant, isn't it? Okay, so... there we go. Bring her to a STOP. So turn that off. Turn off the engine. Put on the handbrake. And hit sleep. That is going to be the end of this video, and we'll take it up in the next video at 40 minutes past midnight with the rain having stopped. So until then, go handy.